Secret that I am my biggest fan. Crank this motherfucker up. I want the folks at the Dave and Buster's in the red rapping. I gotta tell y'all, I was leaving the hotel and I had my turban on. I was feeling my fantasy. I said, honey, we're back home. And the drag is big in Texas. I can't get your ass somewhere to sit down, all right? I'm giving a very important TED talk, motherfucker. Y'all should have worked all these goddamn kinks out before y'all drove me to this place. Because when I left the hotel, I was so excited. I said, how far? Oh my God, are you getting all this? Thank you. I love your expression, too. I talk a lot, and I talk very fast. And furious. See, I knew it was going to be a spectacle, all right? I mean, come on now, come on. I was me, I knew. But I really didn't know that I was going to be performing in a strip mall, all right? Because I asked him, how far is the theater? Did we blow a speaker in this bitch? I mean, a fuse or something. They got the counter up there too, bitch. I know exactly what's going on here. They said we have Alyssa Edwards. The lady has a lot of things to say. We're gonna put a counter over here because she'll notice she can see her reflection. She'll look over. Y'all see that shit? Everybody turn and look at that. That's all right. Y'all can keep that counter, all right? Because I'm gonna talk. I'm gonna do what I came here to do. And I don't know exactly what that is, but I'm here tonight. You all are here tonight. The director came in the back and said, Alyssa, can you please be mindful? I'm putting some rouge on. I said, be mindful of what? I'm a mindful lady, all right? And they said, can you be mindful of time? I can. What's going on? Well, we have to be out of here at a certain time. I said, motherfucker, don't rush me or I'll take this drag show to the streets of Houston, all right? I know it's a Tuesday night. But when we rounded the corner and we entered the strip mall, I said, oh, are we making a pit stop? He said, no, Alyssa, this is where you're performing. I said, no, it ain't. Can I get some champagne, baby? It's gonna be one of those kind of nights. Do we got a little table or a stool or something I can put on? What the fuck is going on over here? You brought the bottle. You don't know them like that? What if they put a Rohifrenol in that? Bitch, I for surely won't get off the stage. Y'all fucked up real good. And they said, no, Alyssa, the theater is right here. I said, the theater cannot be over here. The Dave and Buster's. Are you eating a sloppy Joe? This is when you know. This is when you know your career has plummeted, bitch. When you are up in a goddamn strip mall on a Tuesday night and folks are eating chicken nuggets and Tostito pizza rolls, and Sloppy Joes. The devil is alive. But that's all right, I'm here tonight amongst many other beautiful entertainers. Y'all give it up for all the queens and the show. Can we turn on the house lights? Can we turn on? I need to look at this crowd. I need to take a look at this crowd. Can we turn? Y'all didn't hear me? I'll take my time. Can we turn the house lights on, bitch? I know this is a fire hazard. Oh, these folks are up in here. I'm sure everybody was looking. Thank you, baby. See, come to the light, Alyssa, baby. Come to the light. I've been waiting a long time. We got my good girlfriend over here, Miss Silky Nutmeg Ganache. Dr. Reverend Silky Nutmeg Ganache. This is my good Judy. She comes and visits me and my partner over there in Dallas. She done bought her a home here in Houston, Texas. So y'all know all the summer pool parties are gonna be at Silky Nutmeg Ganache. The pool is lovely, all right? Oh wait, what's it? Oh, only men? That's a lie, bitch. I know you for your work. You got a pool boy, Silky? Oh, you're hosting auditions. You're accepting applications. All right. Go over there on I-1. Thank you for the house lights. Oh, my God. Hey, everybody back there and over there and over there. Okay, turn the house lights off and keep the spotlight on me, all right? Don't fuck with me, Houston. Anyhow, is there one heterosexual man in the house? Just one. Just one. Oh my God. Right here. I love that the whole table said right here. I know that there was, I had a feeling there was just going to be one. This whole side of the room said, no, bitch. Wrong queen, mama. Wrong queen. Okay, come on stage, motherfucker. They didn't nominate you. This is not the Price is Right. Baby, can you move this? Sir, can you move this right here, baby? Move this over there. No, the chair and the bottle. How you gonna bring the bottle up on stage? I mean, they told me, baby, you come stand over here beside me and stop moving all around. It's Tuesday night. And as someone told me in the meet and greet, it's a lot of old lady shirts and shorts tonight. That's all right, though. That's all right. I want you to stand right there. What is your name?
Gabriel.
Everybody say hi, Gabriel. Hi, Gabriel. Who are you here with tonight?
I'm here with my family, my wife, and my two daughters.
Your wife and your two daughters. Hi, wife and two daughters. Gabriel looks like a fun dad. You look like a nice man. Hold on, Gabriel, baby. Let me set this right here. Let me properly introduce myself. Gabriel, my name is Alyssa Edwards. It's a southern gentleman right there. I was in Pittsburgh last night. That motherfucker went like this and tried to shake my whole... Son of a bitch, how was you raised? Gabriel, you look like a very nice man. You actually look like you got good credit. Is this the wife? Oh, okay, you look very happy. He's got good credit. And these are the daughters right here. All right, are we taking orders for more pizza? Oh my God, pizza, hot wings. They told me glamour. They told me glamour, and then I had to walk through a kitchen. But back in my day, don't move, I gotta tell a story real quick, all right? But back in my day, I've performed at a lot of places, all right? I'm not saying I'm old, y'all already know I'm just established. I'm seasoned and I'm polished. I'm very thankful and grateful. Oh, I love that, all right. Got the old days right. Thank you, baby, oh my God, cheers to you too, I love you. And I love you for loving me, thank you. Gabriel, you better stop trying to steal the spotlight, bitch. Gabriel, back to you, okay. The reason why I called you up here is because I needed a strong man to help me get my coat off, all right? So I can do my performance. Do you think you can do that? I know you have two kids, but that don't mean shit, all right? You could have purchased them children, I don't know. And Gabriel, by the way, you up here blowing kisses and shit, I'm getting nervous. And these are the daughters right here. How are y'all ladies? I have to say, what cool parents that they come with y'all to a drag show on Tuesday night. Is this where I gotta stand and get some air conditioning? Baby, oh my God, oh my God. It's gonna be one of those kind of nights, I can already tell. All right, Gabriel, so I want you to help me take my coat off, and I want you to do it very, well, Gabriel, have you ever seen a special kind of lady like myself before? Oh, you saw me on television? Did you see me win? Houston, Texas, I won twice. Show I got crowned in my head, but I'd like to think that I got the bigger win in the end, win in the hearts of the people all around the world, and having the opportunity to travel. I was fancy, I was getting in first class up in the sky. Did you get that, honey? Thank you. First class, honey. First class. Got my eye on you too. Got Gabriel to the right, you to the left. Bitch, if we put a wig on you, you got a job for real. You up here signing and shit like that. Okay, I love all that. That's all right, Gabriel. But you did see me on there. You know what? Hold on, Gabriel. I'm gonna tell you something, Houston. I thought I was going to the world's largest pageant when I went on that television show, because here's the thing, I was already Miss USA once upon a time, and I was a gorgeous Miss Texas, a lovely Miss All-American Goddess, and a fierce Miss America for 30 days. Until that bitch, she snatched that fucking crown off my head, girl. I was plucked, all right? But that wig did not move, honey, because you can't keep a good hoe down, and I kept it moving. And when I walked into Drag Race, I'm no season, let me see, what number are we on right now? God bless, we got some Drag Race fans in the house. Well, season 30, hosted by Michelle Visage, is gonna be the uncut, raw, and uncensored version of Drag Race. And I know for a fact I'm probably gonna be about probably 70% of that. Because let me tell y'all, when I walked in, I mean, well, first of all, let's go back, all right? For me to get there, they had to really trick me, because I said, I'm not entering no more pageants right now, I'm taking a break. I'm on hiatus from pageants. I'm working over here at my dance school, for those of you that live under a rock. I own a dance studio in Mesquite, Texas, named Beyond Belief Dance Company. I'm very proud to say I've been a teacher, a leader, and a mentor for 22 years. Did you all see my dance kiddos on America's Got Talent? Okay. Well, if you did not vote for them and you're not a Christian, get the fuck out, all right? Go on over to the Dave and Buster's. God bless Houston, Texas. I walk in, I said, hold on, Gabriel, okay, baby? And stop fidgeting and move around. I need people to look at me. I walk in, I said, where are my background singers? Where are the dancers? Where are the feather fans? I want to feel like Anne Margaret for all the old gays, but of course the old gays. The young gays are like, bitch, we only know Taylor Swift. That's a damn shame, all right? But I love Taylor Swift too. Don't go on Reddit talking about Alyssa Edwards is not a Swiftie. I'm a Swiftie girl by default, but the kids do. Oh my gosh, the fan is on high over here. We should have put that in the middle, but that's all right. They said, oh, Alyssa, we don't need all that. I said, no, you're wrong. I don't need all that. No feather fans, no dancers, no nothing. Make sure the microphone works and the spotlight and push play. So here I am. But anyhow, Gabriel, I lost the pageant, not once, but twice. I was a lovely runner-up, though, a lovely, all right? But my favorite moment, though, is when they called and told me, Alyssa, we really want you to come be on RuPaul's Drag Race. And I said, I don't really know about that. I can't go cross-dressing on television in front of my grandmother. And then the second call was, this is what got me, all right? Not the money, not anything else. They said, well, Alyssa, it just makes sense. Alyssa Edwards in Hollywood. And I sat there and I said, hold up. Like the Hollywood, Joan Collins Hollywood, Elizabeth Taylor, I'm coming. And I packed my purse, I got on a plane, and I walk in the first day, and I see RuPaul, and I said, oh my God, RuPaul Charles, I saw you on television, you were on Tu Wong Fu. I've been wanting to tell you. And she said, well, Alyssa, walk up these stairs. And I saw a water tank. And I said, well, what are we going to do here? And they said, Alyssa, walk up those stairs and jump in that water. And I said, is this the first category for this pageant? Because I don't see the judges. And what are the scores for this category? I said, RuPaul, I don't want to get wet right now. I need to tell you a story. She said, baby, you can tell me your story later. Walk up the stairs. And I kept talking. Y'all know I always take the long route. And I'm getting to walk up the stairs. And she said, Alyssa, do you need any help? Oh, no, Miss RuPaul. You see, I've walked upstairs and downstairs in evening gowns with 5-foot-long beaded Swarovski crystal trains on them. I got this. I got all the way up there. I jumped my gay ass in the water. I almost drowned. I get out the water. Alyssa, do you need help? Oh no, Miss RuPaul. You know I don't need help. And it would be my luck. I call it the Alyssa Edwards luck. That I get all of, I'm telling my story too as I'm walking. I get to the very end of the staircase. I hit that last step and that motherfucking left leg came out from underneath me. And in front of God, RuPaul, and my grandmother at home, I busted my damn ass. And do you all remember this scene in season 5? It was great. I don't trust you, the devil's a lie, whoever said that, but I'm laying there on the ground and I said, are y'all recording this? And Miss RuPaul said, there's a camera there, 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 and there. And I said, well, at least I did it graceful. And I got my gay ass up and I hit it. And you see, I thought I was winning all the categories. That's why I thought my Katy Perry was so good. Until I was apologizing and tweeting and shit like that. And then I found myself in the bottom again, getting sent home to Coco Montrese. Don't you be booing, this ain't the Sharon Needle show, all right? Y'all really got the wrong queen over here in this strip mall, Houston style. Y'all need to stop that shit. The fucking Red Robin next door, all right. I'm gonna make a documentary. I'm gonna make another documentary. Another documentary, how about that? And I'm gonna include this tour that they came on, all right, that they told me I was coming on in the strip mall. I'm gonna have Houston, Texas up in this bitch. Home sweet home, there's no place like it. But then I went back to All Stars 2, we all saw that. We surely did, all right. The girls were voting folks off the island. Did you see that, by the way? Houston, I feel very attacked. Like my daughter did in that Untucked. I feel very attacked up in this bitch. But anyhow, my grandmother, who is my hero, she saw me and she called me up and she said, Justin, I saw you on television dressed up like a woman. And I said, well, Granny, what did you think about that? She said, well, I have always thought you was beautiful, you was kind, and you was smart. But I think it is very unbecoming of a lady from the South like yourself to be on television using all them curse words. And I said, I'm so sorry, I can't help it, Granny. I just, you know, I get carried away and then I start talking. And believe it or not, Houston, I was a very shy child. I know that's hard to believe. I'm 1 of 7 from a quintessential Southern family. I had a father who believed girls wear pink and boys wear blue. And then there's me, his first son, all right? And my dad set out on a mission to make me the all-American boy, and after a few broke arms in football and a black and fucking blue and a broke eye socket in baseball, I found myself in a jazz dance class. Thank God for the jazz dance class at George Sharp School of Dance. My dad wasn't having nothing to do with it, all right? But my granny, you see, she hated my father from day one, and she was looking for a reason to get rid of his ass, and I was gonna give her a few. So she moved me into her house. I was Priscilla before there was a Priscilla, Queen of the Desert, bitch. I was Priscilla, Queen of Mesquite, twisting and twirling, and all the old gays know that reference, but you all right, baby? All right. We good? We good. Okay. All right. I love you for loving me, like I told you earlier. Now, son of a bitch, if you don't want to act fucking right, bitch, I'm gonna show you how much I love you. But anyhow, back to my favorite subject, me. And, you know, she said, but here's the thing. She watched the episode when I was behind the mirror, and the girls were trying to vote me off the island. They surely the fuck were. She said, Justin, I saw you on television dressed up like a woman again. Yeah, Granny, that was me. Uh-huh, that was you, all right. But this would have been one time I would have given you a free pass. Because I was hoping you was going to jump through that mirror and cuss all them fucking ladies out. And I said, Granny, that's all right. I didn't have it in my heart, even though I did. Uh-huh. I said, but, you know, I'm going to make the best of it, and I did, and then I found myself making Alyssa's Secret, and then Netflix called me for Dancing Queen, and, you know, that's that good money, all right? And by this time, I knew what Hollywood was when that phone rang, and I looked over, and it said, fucking Netflix. Bitch, I dove over that audit. I picked up that phone. Thank you for calling the household of Alyssa Edwards. This is Miss Edwards. Not only am I the president, but I am a client. And then I found camera crews all in my house, all in my dance school. Did you all enjoy Dancing Queen? Did you see that, Gabriel? Just say yes. Don't fuck with me, Gabriel. Thank you, baby. Okay. Okay, Gabriel. This is my show, not yours. But I just needed you to come here and take my coat off. I'm sorry, I had to get my TED Talk real quick. It's a very important speech. And we do thank you for supporting Drag Race, all right? Gabriel, have you ever put on a satin dress before? I think you should. All right, come on, Gabriel. I want you to unzip. Get over here, baby, stop. Don't you come running at me like I don't fucking trust you. But y'all fuckers over here in Houston be acting up. I want you to unzip my coat real. So take your time, baby. Take your time, okay? We ain't making fucking kids, bitch. That's a whole nother fee, all right? A whole nother fee. Is the credit good, though, for real? Hold on, Gabriel, because one thing my granny taught me, y'all, Justin, when you get to a point in your life when you want to fall in love, you make sure you don't worry about nothing else but a good FICO score, all right? And I did just that because love is alive in my life right now. I'm so very thankful and grateful that I found my partner all the way in Chicago. I had to move him to Texas. I said, hey, it's too fucking cold up there for me. And see, he's the doctor that teaches the doctors, all right? And so, and good credit. Oh, look at all this nice. You see all this nice shit? This is good Dolly Parton drag, bitch. Okay. All right, baby, we're gonna take this coat off. We're gonna be very, very, very soft and slow. And then you're gonna get behind me and assume the position. Are you ready? Bitch, do I look ready? Look at this, you better get up close. Okay, all right, here we go, you ready? All right, Gabriel, I believe in you, okay? That's like the supersizing of the feet when you start touching, all right? Okay, Gabriel, come on, you're gonna get behind me and pull this coat off. Treat me like the woman I am, all right? By the Red Robin. Don't come grabbing at my face like that. Gabriel, where are you from? Houston, Texas? It fucking is sad, I can tell. That's about right. Where are you from? Raised in New Orleans. That's why you just get real handsy with me. You're a who? A Cajun. Maddie never heard of that. A Cajun Mexican? You're exotic. Get this coat off me. Oh my God. Get this. Come on, Gabriel. Get behind me, Daddy. Come on. Don't snatch me fucking bald in this bitch, man. Gabriel, if you yank my fucking wig off, I will do my show bald headed because the check already cleared and there's no refunds. But I would like to have my good hair off. Right here. How do y'all have sex? First date I went on, I gotta tell this part. Do y'all watch Alyssa Secret in here? My very first Alyssa secret was, Alyssa, tell us about your first date. I went on a date with the Cajun bastard. And that fucker took me to Red Lobster. I was okay with the Red Lobsters. I like the biscuits. And this was my back rolls era. And so I was okay with it. But then when the check came, he slid the check to me. I said, what's that? You called and invited me on a date. And now you want me to pay? Yeah, come on, Cajun, get your ass up here. Get behind me, grab right here from behind me and take this coat off me. We don't got time, come on. Cute for you. Everybody give Gabriel a round of applause. Gabriel, take my coat over there and give it to this nice young gentleman up there. Don't try to steal it because you look like you would try it on, alright? I'm not having it. Alright, Houston, I'm going to do me this little number and we're going to carry on while you eat your hot wings or whatever the fuck you're going. Wow. The story of my life, from Hollywood to Houston in the restaurants. That's all right, I'll take it. All right, DJ, crank this motherfucker up and let's have some fun. Come on, hit it, DJ. Bring it up loud, too.